Now friends, come to this particular page, residential status of HUF, Hindu undivided family. Before I just go ahead, friends, I want you all guys to give you an introduction of the residential status here. As I already told you that up to now what we had already discussed was residential status of an individual. Now we are going to residential status of some other persons. First person that we are going is HUF. Hindu undivided family. Hindu family is by itself an assessable entity, is also one type of person who is subjected to the taxation. And the residential status provisions are very unique. I repeat, very unique in this particular regards. Okay. Now, first of all, you refer to the BAR Act. Okay. Section 6. One second, let me erase this. Okay, see section 6. Okay, section 6 subclause 1 is about residential status, being resident, but this is for individual. Okay, now for HUF. HUF is subclause 2. Okay, Hindu undivided family, HUF, or a firm or association of person will be said to be resident in India. They will be said to be resident in India. Okay. In the previous year, in every case, except. So it is something like that. Okay. HUF, firms, and association of persons. Okay. You will be resident in all the situation except. Okay. So, exception. Okay. During that year, the control and management of its affairs is situated wholly outside India. Exception is if the control or the management is wholly outside India. It should be wholly outside India. So, if it is wholly outside India, in that particular case, you will be regarded as a non-resident. Or put it differently, if I want to simplify that particular thing, okay, if it is wholly or partly inside India, if it is wholly or partly the control and management, if it is inside India, then you will be regarded as a resident, and otherwise you will be regarded as a non-resident. Okay, these provisions of subclause 2, listen very carefully, is applicable to HUF, firms, and association of persons. Okay. Now, this particular point, I have also given it to in a simplified version here. See this particular page in our material, okay, which I have already shared with you. Okay. HUF, okay, firms or AOP, whole of the control and management, if it is outside India, then you are non-resident. In all other cases, you will be inside India. Now, all other cases, logically, you can write, if at all you want to write, you can say wholly or partly inside India, if the control and management. So, here the main test is of the control and the management, and control and management is basically the key decision of the business or of the activity, where the key decisions are being taken. That particular place is the most important place in order to decide the residential status of the HUF. Firm or an association of persons. Okay. Now, further. Okay. Further. So, now come to this particular, let me come to this particular point of not ordinarily resident situation. Yeah. Let me erase this first of all, because then we will be in the better position. Okay. Section 6.6, which defines not ordinarily resident, Okay. In this subclause B, HUF. Now, not ordinarily resident in the given situation is applicable only in relation to the HUF provisions. Okay. In other words, I already told you that individual or an HUF can have three residential status, resident and ordinary resident, not ordinary resident or non-resident. Okay. However, if the assess is a partnership firm or if it is an association of person, then you can be either resident or non-resident. That means the middle status of not ordinarily resident is not there in that situation. And that's the reason this not ordinary resident provision is applicable only with respect to the Hindu undivided family. Okay. And Hindu undivided family whose manager who has been a non-resident in India 9 out of 10 previous year preceding that particular year or has during 7 years preceding that particular year in all amounting to in all 729 days or less. In fact, this condition is very much similar to individual condition, very much similar. But here, the manager of that particular HUF or in our traditional world, it is also called as a karta. Karta is basically the person who is the head and brain of the family. That head and brain of the family, in English, we call him as a manager. However, in traditional words, we call him as karta. Okay. So, if karta satisfies, the karta has to satisfy that 7 years preceding test or 10 years preceding test, the residential status test. Okay. And if karta satisfies, then you will be not ordinarily resident. Otherwise, HUF will be resident and ordinary resident. In other words, the residential status of HUF, not ordinarily resident, depends on, I repeat, the not ordinary resident status of an HUF depends on the stay and the other conditions of the manager. That means the karta of the family. That you got to keep it in your back memory. Okay. Now here also I have already developed that particular format for this particular HUFC. Just like other structure that I have already made it. Okay. So here also residential status of HUF, resident, non-resident will depend upon the control and management. However, if this particular HUF is a resident, okay, in that particular case, not ordinarily resident condition will be applicable with respect to the manager. With respect to the manager of that particular family. See, I've already mentioned resident, not ordinary resident based on the stay of the karta. This is the point that I've already made. And accordingly, we have to take the decision whether you are not ordinarily resident or a resident and ordinarily resident. Is that clear? And last thing before I just in fact that is also repetition only, but I will tell you repetition only, but I would like to tell you and repeat that one second. Okay. See, residential status, resident and ordinarily resident, resident but not ordinarily resident or non-resident. Okay. Individual or HUF can have either of the status. HUF can have either of the status. But if it is a firm, AOP or any other person, okay, they don't have not ordinarily resident status. That option they don't have because there is no provision in that regards. So they can either be resident or they can be non-resident. Okay, that is one of the key difference, because this not ordinarily resident provision sometime back, which I explained that to you, that is only for the HUF in the given circumstances. Come to this particular question now, which is based on the residential status of an HUF. Question ID number 31, head office of RG Hindu Undivided Family situated in Singapore since 1980. The family is managed by Mr. R, age 61, who is resident in India in only 7 out of 10 years preceding the previous year, 2009-10. Mr. R stays in India every year for 100 days since past 20 years. HUF is a house property in India from which net computed income is 3,65,300. Determine the residential status of family and assessment year 11-12 if the affairs of the family of the business are wholly controlled from Singapore, partly controlled from India, partly controlled from India, and Mr. R stays in India for 150 days. Make a correction, friends. It is not, make it as 200 days. Make a correction in the question. 200 days every year since past 20 years. Make this correction in the question. Okay. Now, first of all, HUF is situated in Singapore. So since they are asking you the residential status with respect to the HUF, in order to decide resident or non-resident, first of all, you need to know the test of control and management. Okay. So, all the data about Mr. R and all that is given, who is Karta, basically the manager of the family. HUF is a house property in India from which the net computed income is this figure. So tax liability related thing is relevant. Now, from tax liability point of view, remember one thing, that HUF tax rates is similar to individual tax rate, the tax rates I am saying. However, HUF is not eligible for rebate under section 87A. Okay, because 87A rebate is applicable only to individuals, resident individuals. Okay, so HUF is anyway not entitled to that particular rebate. Okay, so now, first thing, different situations have been given. And we have been asked to calculate the residential status. Now, first situation, for the assessment year has been given. So, this always we should convert it into previous year. So, previous year, only we should think like that whenever the question on the residential status come. Otherwise, many students confuse on this particular front. Okay. Now, if it is wholly controlled from Singapore, then it will be regarded as a non-resident. Okay, so that is, if it is wholly outside India, you are non-resident. In all other situation, you are resident. That means if it is wholly or partly inside India, then it will be regarded as a resident. So straight away you are non-resident. That is the first point. Okay, so see, this is one format which I have already kept it very ready. Okay, and you just have to update your answer. Most of the format is ready. Residential status test based on control and management. Since it is wholly controlled from Singapore, that is basically outside India, so HUF is a non-resident. Okay, now since HUF is a non-resident, there is no need to test further. So this point that we have always understood, that see, the HUF residential status, either you are resident or you are non-resident. If it is a non-resident, this is a final answer. Okay, so there is no further test in case if the assessee is already decided to be a non-resident. If assessee is a resident, then we can test further. Resident but not ordinarily resident, or resident and ordinarily resident. And this is to be applied only if assessee is a resident. This is very well accepted interpretation. However, little bit debatable sometimes, but this is very well accepted interpretation in terms of the residential status. Okay, so our straight away you have got that particular answer, that HUF is a non-resident, so no further discussion, and straight away you can calculate the tax liability. So your first part of the answer is over. Okay, so you can update your tax liability. 87A rebate, keep that in mind. Okay, second situation, if it is partly controlled from India, that means HUF will be resident. Now all the answer that we are giving with respect to the HUF, so HUF will be resident. Okay, because it is partly controlled. So second part of the answer now. Okay, since it is partly controlled from India, that means partly from outside India, whatever you say. Since partly controlled from India, it is resident. Okay. That's all. Now, the test for not ordinarily resident test will be applied based on the stay of Karta. The test is very much similar to individual test, but here we will have to see now whether in past 7 years preceding the previous year, whether the Karta, the manager of the family, did stay in India for how many number of days, and accordingly we have to test. Then he was, for how many number of years he was non-resident, and accordingly we have to test. Now I think in the question, out of 10 years, I think 7 years he is given to us as resident. Let me check. Okay. He was resident in India only 7 out of 10 years. So 7 years he is resident, that means 3 years he is non-resident. So that I can straight away update that 3 years he is non-resident. Okay. So at least 9 out of 10, at least 9 out of 10. So this condition is not satisfied. Okay. Now the further test. Okay. In the preceding previous year. Okay. Now, Mr. R stays in India every year for 100 days since past 20 years. So, every year he is staying 100 days. So, in past 7 years, he must be staying 700 days. Naturally. So, his number of days stay in past 7 years would be 700 number of days, which is less than or equal to 729 number of days. And under 6-6, it is this condition in order to become not ordinarily resident. Okay. And thus the HUF will be here. It should be HUF. Okay. The HUF will be because the stay of manager, but the decision that we are taking is a residential status of the HUF. Keep that in mind. Okay. So, his HUF will be not ordinarily resident because this condition is satisfied. Stay is less than or equal to 729 number of days. And therefore, HUF will be not ordinarily resident. And since the HUF is a not ordinarily resident now, you can straight away go and compute the tax liability, because tax liability is just the plain situation in this particular question. So that's not a big deal whatsoever. Now the third part of the question. Now in the third part of the question, the HUF is partly controlled from India. So since you are partly controlled from India, HUF will be regarded as a resident. Now that we have already understood. Okay. And Mr. R, make a correction, and this is not 150 days. I have already corrected to 200 days. Mr. R stays in India for 200 days every year since past 20 years. So now he is staying for 200 days, and moment he is staying for 200 days, let me tell you, since past so many years, which is more than or equal to 182 days. Okay. So every year he is going to be resident. Every year he is going to become resident. Who is going to become resident? Mr. R. Okay, so if I update my answer now, okay, since it is partly from India, the HUF will be resident. The answer which is given is for resident. Okay, now since you are already resident, you have to test whether you are not ordinarily resident. Okay, but it will be based on the stay of manager, stay of the karta. Now karta is staying for 200 days every year, so he is in past 7 years, because every year is 200 days, so 1400 days he has stayed in India. Okay, and he is going to be non-resident not even for a single year, because every year he is going to become resident, because 200 days if every year he is staying in India, he is going to become resident. So non-resident is going to be for not even a single year. Okay, so now in the given situation, he is not satisfying any of the condition. This is not satisfied, this is also not satisfied, and thus the HUF will be resident and ordinarily resident. Mamma mia. Thus the HUF will be resident and the ordinarily resident. In other words, the additional condition, I repeat, the additional condition will have to be applied with respect to the not ordinarily resident condition will have to be applied with respect to the manager or the karta of that particular family. Is that clear? Okay, so HUF will be resident and ordinarily resident, and you can calculate the tax liability based on that particular status. However, tax liability will not make a big difference here, because anyway it's only one Indian income, and the tax liability will have to be considered. However, 87A rebate in the tax liability is not to be given to the HUF, because this entire answer is given with respect to the HUF only. Now come to this particular question, ID number 32. D is a karta of HUF and controlling manager of the family is wholly situated in India. On 30th April 2016, D went to Bangladesh for business purpose and did not return till 31st of March 2017. D did not go out of India any time before. What would be the residential status of HUF for the assessment year 17-18? Taxable income of HUF is 2 crore and 60 lakhs of rupees. Okay. So, first of all, this assessment year, we will always convert it into previous year from the residential status point of view for better understanding. Okay. So, previous year will be 16-17, where assessment year is 17-18. Okay. Now, for the previous year 16-17, first of all, we will have to see the control and management, the wholly situated in India. The control and management is wholly situated in India. So, straight away, we can go to the format of notes. Okay. The control is wholly from India. And thus, HUF is resident. Thus, the assessee is resident. Is that okay? Now, not ordinarily resident based on the stay of karta. So, HUF residential status, first of all, based on control and management. And thereafter, in order to decide not ordinarily resident based on the stay and other conditions of the karta, the manager of that particular family. Okay. So, since HUF is already decided now as resident, okay, so previous year 16-17, so previous year 16-17 and now before years, because that 7 years total and all that will be required, no? Okay, for 16-17 previous year, he stay in India, he left on 30th of April. And he did not return till 31st of March. So, his stay in India for that previous year is just 30 days. April 30 days. Okay. And before that, and did not return till this. D did not go out of India anytime before. That means all the earlier years, D is inside India. All the earlier years. See this, D did not go out of India anytime before. So, in all the earlier years or before this particular travel to Bangladesh, he was always in India. So, it all 365 days. So, you can just say 365 into 7 and you will get 7 years stay, because you want 7 years before the previous year. Okay. And naturally, for all the before the previous year, he was staying in India for 365 days. His residential status will also become resident for all the years. So, seven years preceding the previous year will be 365 into 7. It's going to be a very high number. I think I get an answer 2555. Just check. Okay. So, anyway, this condition is not satisfied because his stay should be less than or equal to 729 days in order to become not ordinarily resident. Okay. And non-resident, zero number of years. Because every year in the preceding 10 years, he was always in India. So, since he was always in India, he would have been resident in India. Okay. So, even this condition is not satisfied. Therefore, the HUF is, okay, resident and ordinarily resident. Because any of the condition of not ordinarily resident is not satisfied. So, HUF is going to become resident and ordinarily resident, and accordingly you can calculate the tax liability. That's all. Okay. Now, one more extra point that I want to bring to your notice. Very, very valuable and where the students sometimes confuse. So, HUF residential status is decided. Answer is over. That resident and ordinarily resident. However, the personal computation is not asked in the question. See, if you read the question very carefully, you have to decide the residential status of the HUF only. you have to decide the residential status of the HUF only for this particular year. Okay. So, B, Mr. D residential status is not required in the question. See, Mr. D personal residential status is different and Mr. D HUF residential status is different. So, HUF is different assessable entity, different person. Mr. D per se is a different person. Okay. So, Mr. D, suppose if they ask in the question, his previous year stay is only 30 days in India. His previous year stay is only 30 days in India. Okay. And therefore, Mr. D will become non-resident in India. And so, this particular question, supposing if they ask you personal computation of Mr. D, it will be non-resident. However, the HUF is resident and ordinarily resident. So, the message which I want to tell you is here in this particular case, that it is possible that HUF is resident and ordinarily resident. However, Karta is a non-resident. It is possible that HUF and Karta can have different residential status because individual is governed by different provisions and HUF is governed by different provisions. Is that absolutely clear in this particular situation? Okay. And now you can just do the tax liability calculation. It is very simple, but this is tax liability of the HUF.